Huh?
Go.
Everybody say aye.
I got a football.
Yeah. We got football. We're going to play the field out back.
Go, yeah. I tell you what we'll do.
Here we go.
We'll give you 124, we'll give you 12. You and Rob 12.
What?
Make it a fair game.
I was going to say, y'all's shots count for what, four? Or you just want to shoot 2 6 pointers.
Hey.
That's it.
Yeah, Cinder,
just
get up.
Girls, kids,
get
up.
I have no idea if it's going to record or not. I think I'm recording, I don't know.
Bill's not here either.
Trevor.
Deal with this handle or
well, that was nice.
Or glass
or what's up?
They said take
pictures of it,
measure it, they'll see how much it
will cost to replace
it. So they're replacing my whole
house.
Oh, that's good.
Can you live here?
Hey, Mama.
I'm surprised I am too. They're replacing my whole house.
Oh, wow.
But you know, they really should, because
yeah.
they could get a terrible.
Well,
house.
I told them, I said, look, I
followed your directions. I had
you know,
the
direction.
Yeah.
Right.
They do.
They do.
They say all their candles self consume. Yeah. Wrong. I had a 5-foot red candle sitting on a
coffee table.
There you go, Deb's good.
No more pictures.
There you go.
I don't know.
Give him a hug.
Hello.
Thank you, baby.
Now it's your turn. Give it a kiss, Polly.
You give a kiss.
Oh.
No, you can't give it. Did you get his face?
Oh.
That's cute. Yes. You can take that to 99.
Hey, Sherry.
Is it locked?
I know. We can.
But is it locked?
Yeah. There's a what's over there. Do you see that?
You're so what? I'll take care of that tonight.
Thank you.
You're coming in, bud.
You guys were locked out?
I know you are.
Mommy, it's spider.
That's spider. Here you go.
Spider. Take it or you leave it.
Hey, Fred, where you going? Hey, Fred. Fred.
Now I'm going to have to scare
him. I'm not sure. Yes, that's my chance!
Okay.
babe.
Bye bye, people. I love you.
Hey, sing my cow.
No, no, no. I think.
Y'all do Backstreet Boys. Y'all get over there with Shannon and do it.
This is cold right here.
Casey.
Let's not splash, guys.
Shannon, get back over to the side.
Okay, we don't want to have to fill it back up.
Ooh, I got a little boy's bobo.
Want me, Sissy, to help you?
Yeah.
Okay, come on.
Sissy,
this is the view from our cabin. Mount Lafayette.
Can you get in there with Sissy?
On top of old Smokey. There's bars down there in the woods.
Can you touch?
There's the family inside, watching family videos, laughing at themselves when they were young.
Sissy, are you all right? Yes. Sissy, talk to me.
Daddy!
Trevor's in here!
Give me a hug. Yes. Don't you know any other verse?
Stand up.
And I'm one. His love is strong. His love is strong. Good. When a heart gets weak, the road gets long. His love is strong.
Pals for a little girl. You hurt your toe again.
Hey,
good night. Tell Dad good night.
Good night, Daddy.
Tell me good night, Shannon. Tell me good night, Casey.
Casey, if you get cold one night, this blanket's right here, okay? Just reach over.
We need to turn the heat off or something.
Turn
the heat on?
Been doing that day.
Ah! Oh,
yes!
Where are we going?
We have to go up and down.
Up and down. Where are you going?
Hey,
Dad, I have got your official comment about the golf game today.
I didn't know what you were talking about. Well, there we go. Go. There. Oh, feature dancer. I'm not that cool.
Oh no! Oh my God! Barbara,
get in there!
See, I'm fine.
Get in! Get her, Mom! Get her! Yes. No, I want the other Moomoo back.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Flashing everywhere, everywhere you look.
Wherever you know, Dan.
I can take
my hair, that's right.
That's all I
do. Do you know if you have a stray camera at your house?
A stray camera?
Yeah.
Hey, I'm a
mom.
Way
up.
Jessica Lynn, what are you doing?
She learned that from your sister.
Hey, Debbie.
Hey, Daddy.
Hey, Shannon girl. I love you more.
Yeah, I
love you more.
Call and ask him to give you a description of his hair. He walked off of steps, though. He went down. I mean, he has no fear. He just steps down.
Oh, Trevor likes to jump.
He does with thumb over.
Yeah.
You're getting on that well.
Hey. I see your basketball, boy.
Hey, how are you doing?
Hey,
Debbie.
Oh, I was going to say. Hey,
Gotcha.
Jessica.
Jesse. I haven't seen you. I'm gonna hug your uncle. Jay Uncle Wilson.
I told you.
Yeah,
you
better.
Hey, you mean I know something? Okay.
Did you see
Shannon?
You
sure? Well,
you're pretty good.
I'm a little grown up than
mine. Well, Shannon.
Shannon. Shake him here.
How are you? Do you remember me?
Say hey, Uncle Bill.
Yeah, she's like 6 months.
Say hi, Uncle Bill. Shannon, you're not shy. Say hi to Uncle Bill.
She doesn't remember.
She's not shy.
Come here, Shannon. Hug my neck. Come on.
Give him a hug. I'm not gonna do it, huh?
I don't think so.
Your mom
knows me. Alright, what's I'm saying? Need the least freebies for you.
Yeah. You like to swing, Shannon?
This is very nice. Nice
cabin. Okay,
stab.
Be real careful with the stick. Okay. Oh, you did?
Yeah, he likes Trevor. Trevor, you know, they were chasing each other a while ago. Mm-hmm. Well, that next year they'll
be wild, won't it?
Yeah, both of them.
Trevor, watch the stick, please. Don't throw anything, Trevor, okay?
You know, of course, there's not that much difference between swing and stuff. 200 feet in.
How much you weigh?
Hey, you're good.
About 220.
Another little trap.
What you looking for?
Her purse.
Your purse.
Come on, disco moves. Show us your disco moves.
Come on, disco for it. Hey!
My mama think I've been drinking. Really? I like it out here in the country. Woo! Free and
take it off.
You been talking to strangers?
Yes, I have.
How you doing?
Well, I just live it.
Shannon Lee.
He doesn't like that at all, Kathy. What do you mean he won't eat from you? You just
it's the first thing he's
you
taking.
You didn't offer the right thing.
It's done. Uh-oh. Eat it.
Yeah, okay,
get it.
Boy.
That was their idea.
We're making it to you either?
No, which there was
two hands.
Let's hold one in each hand just in case. Get it?
What do you have? What is that? What are those called?
Here, you can have the one I dropped on the floor.
Huh?
Are they?
I can go out and do the market.
We weren't allowed to try them. Okay.
I'm back.
Oh, you got the picture.
A woman.
You got it.
And those are.
I don't have any more. That's what you
do. Ugly. An old man with money.
They're gone already?
No.
I was thinking, put all three in the form of a bag?
Ready? That's like.
Right there!
My favorite memory of the farm would probably be that we could really be true children. We got to experience things that we never could in the city. We got to smoke life everlasting corn silk. We got to go all over the farm, drive. I think my favorite memory would probably be getting Colonel, catching him wild up. Of course, not really wild, but catching him up when I had a new pair of jeans on and rode him bareback all over the fields up at top of the hill. And then coming down and Mama being furious that I ruined my jeans. As far as my memories, Mamaw and Papa would probably be Mamaw in the garden and trying to teach me about gardening. I mean, she was so patient when I wanted to go look at tortoises or go look for bugs or something. She was always there trying to teach me things. Papa, he was a cantankerous old heart. But he had a heart of gold. And I miss that. I miss that my kids will not experience that. That is a part of life that they need to learn.
Get in here.
And they will never experience the fun and the freedom of really being a child and really, really using your imagination to its fullest. I miss that they will not know our grandparents. Because they had some wisdom about the old school that I don't think we know about. Our kids will never know. And I hate that more than anything. That's what I remember.
Okay. My favorite memory of the farm is the bunkhouse, of course, as probably a lot of people's are, but since I was the youngest, I was, you know, kind of an outsider in the group, not being able to be directly involved. But one day in the bunkhouse, all of us were there, and John and Rob were on horseback kidnapping Sherry and I. Debbie and Janet were pretending to be our motherly figures and tried to rescue us, and it was just a whole day of adventure and a lot of pretend play with all of us. It was a lot of fun. Another farm memory I do remember, though, is vividly being that young was going up there and trying to be part of the older kids smoking cornhusk cigarettes and then actually going to my parents and asking them if I could do it. That's the first time that ever happened. But the my favorite memory of Grandpa. I was on Susie, the pony, and Susie was so stubborn, wouldn't go, of course, was trying to get me on. And this was the first time that Dad let me saddle my horse. And I had done it, but not very tight, obviously. Well, Grandpa took a switch to Susie, and she took off, and so did I. I went sliding down on the saddle, and she stopped, but I was okay, but that was fun. My memories of Grandpa were with the horses, wagon rides with the
the workhorses team and stuff. And I have a real favorite memory of Grandma. It's more of a scenario. It was always waking up there in the morning and smelling her food and knowing that there were going to be fresh apples on the table and fresh vegetables and going to the pantry and there were just tons and tons of stuff. And I have just real distinct memories of her smells, and I guess that is, it ties into her nurturing and caring that I remember so much about her.
Sure.
It's my turn now. Mine aren't as good as yours, I'm picky.
But they're all, everyone's are good.
Well, one of my memories involves a horse too. It was Colonel though. And it was actually, I took my friend Darcy down to the farm with us. And Colonel was being stubborn, and he's not normally a stubborn horse, but he was. And she told me to take a switch to Colonel. Well, when I did that, Colonel tore off across the bottom meadow there, and I thought that I was going to die. Because I thought that, I mean, he was cantering. I thought that we were going to end up in the creek. He slowed down, and I didn't fall off the horse and break my neck, so that was a good thing. But I never did that again, so idiot me. What else? Oh, I can't think. Grandma. I just remember, too, Grandma was always, she was so giving, wanted to give you stuff. And I remember her trying to always give us, like, hand-me-down clothes and things to wear. And it was like, she was so nice about it, but you were like, well, that's okay.
You don't really want it.
These galoshes and these, you know. But she, you know, she always had something for you to wear if you needed it. And then Grandpa, just his, I don't know, just all, I love just his nicknames and everything. They were great. Like Brown Eyed Possum and all those things. Just remember just the way about him, I guess.
One of his other ones was the music. Definitely the music mm-hmm. is something that sticks out in my mind about him. And it was, I just remember John and Rob playing Kiss and
yeah, that,
getting in
yeah.
trouble for the Kiss and Grandpa coming in and turning that shirt off. This is some real music, and he put on his 8 tracks. You're like, what is this? Ironically, now that's the music that I enjoy listening to is bluegrass. And, my dad gets a big kick out of that now. I get a big kick out of it thinking about how much I felt tortured by Grandpa.
You'll see.
I'm scared.
No,
no.
Dad, you could go on forever when you start.
You can't.
Yeah. I just keep thinking of things.
My favorite memory when the whole family was together was once we were taking pictures. And I set up the camera to take pictures automatically, and the first shot went off without me in the picture, and then I had to go back and reset it again for a longer period of time. Everybody's laughing their head off. And then I took off again to try to beat the camera, and I got about halfway in the picture, about like this. And then the third time I finally made the picture and everybody cheered. That was a very, very pleasant memory. Also, I remember my dad walking John down the lane one time when John was a little small boy. And I just remember the moment with the elm tree blowing in the wind and John and Papo together. And, of course, I remember Mother always being very happy to see the grandkids and running from the garden to say hello to everybody and smiling and having a big hat on her head and a big smile for everybody. And those were some of my memories.
I would think my favorite memory of the farm would probably be when I was probably a junior or senior in high school, and I woke up one May morning. Mother and Dad woke me up, and we had a mare give birth to a colt. I never will forget it. Dad was just enthused, and just a wonderful time. And in terms of my favorite memory, probably me going squirrel hunting. I used to enjoy that. went back on the hill there, just back of the house, and set it in the woods. I can still remember it. Wonderful time.
And the grandmother and grandfather?
Well, that's. I remember hunting with Dad quite a bit. I always enjoyed that. I remember one special time we went one squirrel hunting back. I was probably 15 or 16 years old, and I think we killed two squirrels each. But I never will forget. Wonderful, wonderful time. A lot of wonderful experiences with her. Geez. I don't know. I guess one of the things I always kind of enjoyed with working with her is in her garden. Vegetable garden. It's taught me a lot. And in fact, I still using some of the things she taught me today. So that's probably one of the most memorable things with her.
Well, as I'm standing here and I'm thinking about almost being a member of this family going on almost 40 years. I have a lot of fond memories of Mamaw and Papaw Compton. I think that my fondest memory of her was that we were all sitting around one afternoon. All the girls were talking. They were all teenagers. And they were at the stage of their life where they were talking about boyfriends and making love. I know that Janet asked Mamaw if she ever made love on the back of the hillside. And she said, oh yes, I did have many, many times. And then she kind of dropped her head. We thought, you never thought of your grandmother as being a young girl. But she had been a beautiful young girl. And she became the mother of my husband, whom I adore. And she was a wonderful grandmother to my children, and she was just an all-round good person. The only sad thing about Mrs. Compton, I had to wait almost too late to realize how much she meant to me and what a wonderful, wonderful mother-in-law she had been for so many years. And I, being young and inexperienced, didn't know. But there's not a day that goes by I don't say a prayer for her. I loved her very much. And Papaw, God bless him. I can see him coming down the lane and walking kind of slow, his head down. Just raising it up a little bit. Acting like, well, here I am. I'm home with all the ones I love. Well, Papaw, we're still here, and we still love you a whole lot. That's all I can say.
All right, I'm ready.
Okay,
my one memory of Grandma Compton, or Mom Compton, was the first time I went to the farm after I was engaged to Ted to meet his mom. We spent the night down in the bedroom that was off of the living room. And I slept in the same room with Claudia. And she was in one bed and I was in the other bed. And it was one of those times when she had her headaches and things like that, and she had bad dreams. And so I woke up in the middle of the night and she was screaming, help, help, help. I'd never met her before. I had met her for about, half a day. And I was hanging on to the bed. I was scared to death because she was screaming at the top of her lungs. And Ted heard her upstairs because he was in the bedroom upstairs. And he came running downstairs and he woke her up. And she told me that she'd had a dream that somebody was trying to steal her wedding band. And she was trying to get them to stop. And so she was screaming, help. Scared the living daylights out of me, though. Okay, next one, right? I think a lot of my memories of the two of them are more with when the children were little and they'd come down and they'd ride the ponies and they'd ride the horses because that's what they looked so forward to. And then with Dad Compton, I guess, sitting there having him pile food on your plate after you've had about three. And he's, oh, you're going to have one more pork chop here. And he piled it on the plate, and he's sitting there going, okay. And I think, you know, all my memories are really, really good, but I think those are probably the ones I remember the most.
Jim, the little color burst on, adds Rob, a lot to the picture.
Hey, Rob, right down here beside me.
Rob, you mind if I pop the
trumpet? No, please wait.
Little remote act here.
Trevor, look at the camera. Oh, I'm what a game. Wait a minute, one more.
Okay, here we go, team.
Nicole, take
it.
Dolly.
Cheese.
Holy
cow.
How
do we have to
It's filming. It's filming. It's filming.
Oh, it's filming?
Yeah. Who else?
I've got a camera.
Yeah. Everybody else want to go up?
Yeah.
No, Kathy, you get in.
Team, no, here, I'll keep taking.
Kathy.
I'm an outsider.
Kathy. We want Kathy.
We want Kathy. We want Kathy. We want Kathy. We want Kathy.
We want
Kathy. See, it doesn't always work. Oh, this is a great picture.
I got to hide.
No, you're not hiding. Can't, where is she? Oh, there she is. Okay, ready? Here we go. One, two, three.
All right, yes.
Okay, one more.
Yeah, that's
what the hell?
Whoa.
That's what my wife says.
Okay, here we go.
One more picture.
All right, got it.
One more picture.
She didn't like to go
Sam,
down there.
Hit me, baby, one more time.
All right, my turn. Take pictures.
Yeah, oh, yeah, that's even better.
One more. Jim, let me take yours.
One more.
No. Let me take yours for you.
One more.
One more.
One more time, please.
Herman.
Oh, well.
You
get
tired of this?
Yeah. Herman.
Guys, now you ought to see the crowd from this side.
Come on, Jeff. Over here.
All right, here we go, folks.
Pop the camera view.
Peace.
How do I look?
Wait a minute, I got to turn my flash on.
Oh, no. Open the lens. Open the lens. Open the lens.
I went down.
Peace.
Yeah.
Welcome to Rush.
No, make it pretty. Make it pretty.
All right, here we go.
Yeah.
One more. One more.
All right.
Hey, you're right. The second one's a lot better.
All right.
Second one didn't flash.
Something happened on the second
one. One more, Jim.
Here we go.
Charge it.
All right.
My eyes are kind of.
Now we're going to go in and. Now we're going in and Shannon is going to perform.
All right.
Is it time?
Oh, yeah.
It's time right. For Shannon.
Shannon, it's time for your performance, darling.
You going to do your program?
Where is it, Ted?
Turn down.
Where the red button is up.
How sweet.
Hey, Larry.
Go on.
My country is a sweet land of liberty. Of the I sing. Land where my father's died. Land of the pilgrims cry. From every mountainside, the freedom ring.
Oh.
for making me. Yeah, you gotta mess up.
That's me. No, I can come out, Mom. Mom, I can come out.
Little
chin. Mom.
That's me.
Come
in. Battery. You know what? I'm gonna buy a new battery.
Hey.
Yeah, we wanna buy it.
Chicago bunch moved down there.
Four of us did. And one has already moved away.
Oh, really?
He moved back to Minnesota.
Run him out of town.
Yeah, he's from Minnesota and he moved back there. He was too far away from home. I don't think he could handle the South.
You know, there's a lot of things the Yankees can't take.
From Minnesota. I mean, it's really different.
What was the guy I talked to a couple times?
So. Scott?
McIntyre?
They're going to call.
You're ripping his face.
I'm going to get out.
Jerry,
get out like the man.
No, no, no special.
Jerry,
ready?
Ready?
Yeah.
I'm going
to go call. He's like, put me to bed.
Daddy!
It must have been a hell of a whooping.
Well, he was back there just chucking rocks and breaking windows like crazy.
Getting mad?
Yeah, he was mad. And then another time, he had this kid down, had his head down the toilet. It's an outdoor toilet.
Oh, so he still had a pretty good drop there.
And he was a little bit upset that time, too.
I mean, I love your baby.
Whose head was he holding down?
Some kid. He's got to fight with.
Pissed him off.
I don't remember.
Together in the morning for pancakes.
Yes, ma'am.
You got your camera?
Yes,
the shooting
right.
Where
is it? Ted. Is that where it is?
Show where your buddy is.
Okay.
Who's your buddy? Where's your buddy?
Quit it. Come on.
Attaboy. Attaboy.
You want to go see your place.
No.
Okay.
We're going to follow you.
Oh, boy, that's going to be fun.
Oh, Lord, Bill, you know where you're going?
Oh. Not really.
Oh.
Thank you for cleaning up, Shannon. Y'all owe Shannon a thank you. She cleaned up all the mess upstairs by herself. Well, y'all were out playing around.
The road just this side of the church. All right, turn right.
Mm-hmm. Grand tour of the place, of course.
Of course.
Where we all were. Come down, Mom. Are you dressed? Mom, Dad's room, kept nice and neat and clean, of course. Right, Nana?
Yes, it's sun.
Go back up. There's.
Trevor, get your shoes on, buddy. Now, you got back your Scrabble game.
Trevor?
Huh?
Just making sure.
Is that your Scrabble game?
No, that's yours.
Bobby?
I didn't bring that.
Bobby?
Now, was that your other Scrabble game?
Nah. I don't know. They're not recording.
Of course I am.
Dad, are you okay?
Sit up.
We're coming out to eat.
We are. What are you eating?